So that the wives can be to their own husband in every way. Husbands, love your wives, even as Christ also loved the church and gave himself for it, that he might sanctify and cleanse it with the washing of water by the word, that he might present it to himself a glorious church, not having a spot or wrinkle or any such thing, but that it should be holy and without blemish. So ought men to love their wives as their own bodies. He that loveth his wife loves himself. But for no man ever yet hated his own flesh, but nourished and cherished it, even as the Lord, the church. For we are members of his body, of his flesh, and of his bones. And for this cause shall a man leave his father and mother, and shall be joined unto his wife. If with confident trust in each other, you are now ready to accept each other as husband and wife, to pursue life's journey together, you will acknowledge this decision by taking each other by the hand, which they've already done. Do you, Marshall, take Felicia, whom you hold by the hand, to be your true and lawful wife, to love and to cherish her in joy or pain, in sickness or health, and forsaking all others, to cleave to her only so long as you both live?
I do.
Amen. Felicia, do you take Marshall, whom you hold by the hand, to be your lawful and true husband, to love, honor, obey, and cherish him in joy or pain, in sickness or health, and forsaking all others to cleave to him only so long as you both live?
I do.
Amen. As a token of this covenant, you will now give and receive the marriage rings, the unbroken circle, which is the emblem of gold, the emblem of eternity, and the gold, the emblem of that which is least tarnished and most enduring. They are to show how lasting is the pledge you have made to each other. And have the ring. Let us pray. Father God, bless these rings. These rings that both the bride and the groom will wear. We pray, God, as you bless these rings, you bless them. You bless their marriage until their life's end. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Marshall, take this ring. Put it on her ring finger. And repeat after me. Felicia.
Felicia.
Amen. With this ring.
With this ring.
I thee wed. In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father. In the
name of the Son.
In the name of the Son.
Of the Holy Spirit.
The Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen. Felicia. Put it on Marshall's hand. Amen. And repeat after me. Marshall.
Marshall.
With this ring.
With this ring.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And the Son.
The Son.
Of the Holy Spirit.
And the Holy Spirit.
Amen. The bride has to do a special tribute to the groom.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. You two at this time will now. Extinguishing the flame that represents the individual while lighting their collective flame, signifying that their love will burn throughout all eternity. And it is so in Jesus' name. So we will also be naked to come to the table, take the communion together. That's one of the first acts of the Marian cup. Understanding that the Lord's broken body, bread representing his broken body, wine representing his shed blood. He said, as often as we do it, do so in remembrance of him. The couple had elected to come to the table together. The first act of a married couple.
Beloved, Solomon says in Ecclesiastes chapter 4, commencing at verse number 9, he says that two are better than one. And then he goes on to say that if one was to fall, he has another to assist him in getting back up. Then Solomon uses wismatic phraseology and says, how can one lay down by himself and bring warmth to his body? But Paul says two are able to warm each other. Then Paul goes, then Solomon goes on further and says that one cannot defend himself adequately, but two together are able to withstand any attack that comes their way. What you have today is three strings, one laid with gold, the other purple, and the other white. Each string holds significant meaning. The gold string represents God, the Lord Jesus Christ, the one who knows everything, the one who sees everything, and the one who is everywhere at the same time. The purple string represents the groom, represents Marshall, a newborn creature in Christ, the leader of his home. The white string represents Felicia and her purity. And as Felicia would bring these strings together as I continue talking, these strings represent a Again, the goal being the Lord Jesus Christ. And how the Lord Jesus Christ will be the glue, will be the thread that will hold this marriage together. For it's easy to separate two strings, but with the gold string in the middle, it's not easy to undo, it's not easy to break. The purple string represents Marshall. And Marshall, I want to say to you today that if you continue to love your wife, and as Paul says in Ephesians chapter 6, submit unto the Lord and love your wife as Christ loved the church throughout your marriage, you will see the love of God shed abroad through you and Felicia. The white string represents you, Felicia. And as you love your husband and honor your husband, God will continue to nurture you, sustain you, and give you strength to your marriage. And Marshall holding on to this string with the gold string in the middle representing God, it signifies that you are inviting God to have authority in your marriage. And I want to suggest and to say to you today that that gold string is what's going to hold you through sickness and through health. That gold string is what's going to make you not feel lonely at night. The gold string will be your covering and your protection. And I suggest to you today, as the Solomon says in Ecclesiastes chapter 4 again, two are better than one. For if one falls, there's another there to aid him and assist him in getting back up. And then Solomon says again, Solomon says, asks a rhetorical question, how can one lay down by himself and keep himself warm? Two are able to bring warmth and comfort to each other. Then Solomon ends that in verse number 12 and says, a cord of three strings is not easily broken. So I say unto you, my brother and my sister, as you represent that purple string, as you represent that white string, remember that it's the gold string that's going to keep the fire burning. It's the gold string that's going to keep the love blazing. And long as the gold string is in its proper place, your marriage will be successful. Marriage will be helpful not only to you, but your marriage will be a blessing to each other. Therefore, when God has joined together, let no man put asunder. Yes.
Therefore, Marshall and Felicia. Felicia and Marshall. Marshall and Felicia and Marshall, by the power and authority invested in me, I therefore pronounce you Marshall and Felicia. Felicia and Marshall. Now pronounce you husband and wife. You may salute your bride.
Thank you. somebody who cares. When I found you, found my most intimate prayer. When I found you, I found what every heart dreams of. When I found you, I found love. When I found you, I found the rest of my life. When I found you, I told all others goodbye. When I found you, I saw my fears fly away like a dove. When I found you, I found love. Found you, found one more reason to smile.